Hello and welcome to my channel, The Danish Readaholic. My name is Silke and today I'm going to be tier ranking all of the books that I read in 2021. I think we all know what a tier ranking is, so without further ado, let's just get into it because I do have like 55 books to talk about. So I'm going to put on my screen recording now and we're going to talk about it. Alright, so I do have 7 tiers here. 6 of them make sense, and the last one is for the books that I don't know where to place. So first up, we have Throne of Glass. I'm gonna put it in great, because I did really enjoy it, and I'm excited to continue with the series, but I didn't really like it enough to put it in love it. At least that's how I feel right now. It's gonna go in great, and I'm excited to continue with this series. Next up, we have this nonfiction called Drabschiffen. That is like a Danish nonfiction regarding true crime. I don't know how to rank nonfictions. I'd actually rather not do it. So I'm gonna put it in I don't know where to put these because I don't know where to put it. Next up, we have The Bunker Diary, which is a YA thriller and the first thriller that I've ever read. I really, really enjoyed this, so it's gonna go in great. Next up, we have The Hundred. I'm gonna put it in good. It was decent, it was a reread, and I am gonna continue with the series, which is why I've decided to reread it, because I had read it a couple years ago, but I wanted to see how it would actually end, and to do that, I would have to reread the first two. Next up, we have this Christmas calendar book that I read in December called Santa Claus's Death. I think I'm gonna put it in good. I did enjoy it. It was strange for like a Christmas story because like in the first chapter Santa Claus died and a bunch of like Christmas elves were murdered. It was just kind of dark and twisted, but it was really good, so I'm gonna put it in good. Next up we have Fire and Flood. I am gonna put it in love it because I did love it. It is very much like Hunger Games meets Pokemon, or at least that's what it's like pitched to be, and I get it. I definitely liked it. I like the characters. I like our main character's little companion. They're called Pandoras, so I like her Pandora. I would definitely recommend it. Next up, we have Pretty Deadly. I'm gonna put it in good. I liked it. There was this one character that I really enjoyed, but I just don't remember her name. I think her name was Ginny. And she was this kind of badass assassin lady thing, and she was so cool. But the rest of the story, I was kind of waiting for it to pick up, and then it did towards the end, so I'm definitely going to give it another volume, but if I don't like the second one, then I'm just not going to do it. And the same kind of goes for the next one with Deadly Class. I feel like this first volume, it kind of had to introduce everyone and introduce what types of people we're dealing with, but it didn't really hook me all that much, so I think, again, I will give this another volume, and if I don't like the next one, then that will just be it for Deadly Class. All right, next up we have The Strange Library. I'm actually gonna put this in good. Would I reread it? You know what? Maybe I would. I have had this for ages and I decided to read it because it was short and I needed short books in December. You know what? I actually ended up liking it, which was a big surprise to me because I didn't like Kafka on the Shore, which is also by Murakami. The next two is gonna go in I don't know where to put these, and that is The Mother Goose Diaries and Queen Red Riding Hood, simply because I would give them like 5 out of 5 stars because it is Chris Colfer and it is a part of the Land of Stories realm. Objectively, they're not a 5 out of 5, but I'm not being objective here. But I really don't know where to put them because I don't feel like they fit with like my creme de la creme, like the top of the top. So they're also gonna go in, I don't know where to put this. Next we have Snow Like Ashes. I'm gonna put it in meh, it's okay. I think I've been very back and forth with this book. When I read it, I was like, oh my god, this is so good. I'm so excited to read the sequel, but I'm not gonna pick up the sequel. Then we have Our Numbered Days. Not for me. Sorry, not sorry. I read it the first time, I think, in 2015, and I loved it back then. Now I really don't. And it was really hard getting through this, which says a lot because it was like 63 pages. Next up we have This Is Where It Ends. I'm gonna put it in meh, it's okay. I enjoyed it. I liked the story. There was this one character that I liked. I'm not gonna say anymore because I'm gonna spoil. It was okay. Would I reread it? Nope. But then again, it is a contemporary, so it wasn't gonna score that high. Next up we have Die Gamle Molbohistorie, which is some folk tales from Denmark, close to this area where I live. I don't know where to put this. Again, nostalgic reasons. I've heard these stories ever since I was a kid, and I just really don't know where to rank them, so I'm gonna put them there. Then we have Monstrous Volume 1. I'm gonna put it in good. I really liked it. I'm just gonna go ahead and take the next one. I'm gonna put that in meh, okay, because I enjoyed it. I still like the character. I still like the story, but I just felt like there was a lot of stuff that I just didn't understand why it was necessary to put in the sequel. But then again, maybe I just read it maybe too quickly. Maybe I didn't get what was going on. But it was just not, you know, working for me. But I am gonna read the third one. If I don't like it, I'm gonna, you know. Then we have Truth Witch. No comment. It just wasn't for me. I understand why some people like it, but it was just confusing for me. I've heard people say that you should read it twice, but I don't want to read books that you have to read twice to love. If I don't love it the first time, I'm not gonna love, like, I'm not gonna read it again. Then we have Three Dark Crowns. It goes in meh, it's okay. I feel like it was the same with this as in with Snow Like Ashes. At first I was like, okay, it ended really well, like I really liked the ending, maybe I'm gonna pick up the sequel. And now that I've had time to like think about it, I'm not gonna pick up the sequel because I don't care about the characters, like any of them. But I'm gonna move on because otherwise I'm gonna get angry. Then we have Snot Girl. I'm gonna put that in love it because I really did love it. I wasn't expecting to. Oh wait, no, I'm not gonna put it. Oh yeah, I'm gonna put it in love. Confusion. I really did love it, and it was reading a lot like contemporary, and normally I don't like that, but for this one I really did. Then we have Cersei. I liked it, okay. It was good. It was okay. I was just confused in like the first half, and then the second half I felt like a lot of the stuff was really boring. I liked the part with Ariadne, which is why I'm also gonna try reading the Ariadne, but if I don't like that, then I might, you know, stay a little bit away from like the Greek adult retellings. But I did like it. I did like the character of Cersei. I'm not gonna reread it. I am gonna keep it, but that's because it's pretty. Then we have The Crowns of Crosswold. I'm gonna go with good because I enjoyed it, and it's very similar in style to Harry Potter and The School for Good and Evil, with like the magical school. So if you're looking for something like that, I would definitely recommend this, and you know, I really enjoyed it. Then we have They Both Die at the End. Don't come for me, please. I am not the biggest fan of contemporaries. This, I would say, is like a contemporary with a little bit of like magical realism maybe, or like a dystopian factor with the whole you get a call when you're about to die. I didn't really care much for any of the characters, and I understand that the story is really sweet and it's very heartwarming and everything. I just didn't care. I'm sorry. And I didn't cry. Then we have The Sun and Her Flowers. That was great. It was good, apparently. Next up we have Incendiary. Incendiary goes in love it. This was a reread. Still love it. I don't really have much to say other than the fact that the book is phenomenal. Then we have Kriya Princessen translated to The Warrior Princess. They're gonna go in, I don't know where to put these because I read them as a kid and I reread them because I was feeling nostalgic. Then we have The Never Tilting World. This goes in great. No, it goes in love it. And I'm gonna follow it up with Heart of Thorns. Both of them are in love it. I really like the story, I like the characters, and I'm excited to continue. So it is just, you know, right now it's to that point where I just need to pull myself together and actually read it. Then we have Land of Stories, Book Hugger's Guide. It's going in, I don't know where to put this. It's Chris Colfer, it's Land of Stories, I'm always gonna love it. Then we have Neil Gaiman, Norse Mythology. It's gonna go in, it's okay. I knew most of the stories already, so it was kind of tough to go through it because I knew almost everything that was gonna be said in each of the stories, and I knew the outcome, so it wasn't that intriguing to me, and it wasn't that exciting because I knew what was gonna happen. Then we have An Ember in the Ashes. Okay, I wanted to put it in Can't Stop Thinking About It, but I've forgotten so many times that I'm currently reading this series, so I feel like that would be lying. So it's gonna go and love it because I do love it, and I am excited to read the sequels as of right now when I'm filming. Haven't read them, but it will get there. Then we have Sushi Rolltop. I'm gonna put it in meh, it's okay. I would maybe consider putting it in I don't know where to put these, but since it's not a reread and not really for nostalgic reasons, I feel like I can be a little bit more objective about it. And it was a fine story. It is really old. I could definitely feel that in the writing. and it took me a while to get through. I'm just gonna put it there. Same goes for Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, Season of the Witch. I didn't like what they've done with the characters. This is a prequel to the TV show, so it's supposed to be like the characters in the TV show, and I really didn't like what they did. And there was a lot of plot holes that didn't make sense when you combined it like with the TV show. Then we have Bone Crier's Moon, no comment, one of my favorite books of all time. Then we have Raven and the Dove, It's Gonna Follow It, also one of my favorite books. I lived in this world for so long after I finished it, it's not even funny. Then we have Mercy, which is a graphic novel, and you know what? It's right up there with them. The character design were stunning, the story was intriguing, like, I loved everything. Then we have Pawn, I'm gonna put it in good. I am probably gonna continue, I haven't really decided yet, but I did like it. It was fine. Then we have The Frost Eater, which goes in, I can't stop thinking about it. If you saw me like the following months after reading The Frost Eater, you will know that I was raving about this book for so long. I still love it, it's still great, and I am excited to continue. Who knows when I will get to that. Then we have Pigen der ville kede sig ihjel. The girl who wanted to bore herself to death. I'm gonna put it in not for me, sorry not sorry. I felt like there was no plot development and no reason behind the main character's actions, so I'm just gonna leave it. Next up, we have Blood Air. I'm gonna put that in great. I feel like enjoyment-wise, it was the same level as A Throne of Glass, so I feel like it fits very well. Rebel Rose, no comment. I've talked enough about this book, and I don't want to talk about it anymore. Then we have Øyligjerne. I really hope that this book was better than it looked. It wasn't. It was so strange. Like, the weirdest book I've ever read. Next up, we have Light as a Feather. I'm actually gonna put it in... I'm gonna put it in meh, it's okay. I am gonna continue with the series because I do own the rest of it, and I'm excited to see if I like the next ones better, because I did watch the TV show, like, the first season, and I think that because I knew what was happening, like, 80% of the time, I feel like I might have enjoyed this less than I would had I not known. Next up, we have Rosalila og hennes venner. I'm gonna put this in, I don't know where to put these, because another nostalgic read for me. My mom used to read these to me when I was a kid, so obviously I'm gonna love them forever. Then we have Goldilocks. One might say that I should put it in I don't know where to put this, because it is also Lane of Stories, but I am actually just gonna put it in great. I really like the story, I like the character design of Goldilocks, she looks just like I imagined, and I'm here for it. I like the story and the fact that she came together with all these kind of misfits with magical powers, and I just loved it. And the magical powers were hilarious, so I'm here for it. Then we have Tale of Magic, can't stop thinking about it, such a great story, cried multiple times, it was the best. Then we have The Hunter and the Mage. I'm gonna put it in great because I did not love it like nearly as much as I did the first one, and I'm kind of anxious for the next one, but I do think that The Hunter and the Mage ended up really well, so hopefully the next one will be rather intriguing, but we'll see. Next up, we have Fable. Fable is gonna go and love it. That was great, and I need to continue. That's all I have to say. Then we have Illusionary. Best book of the year. Kingdom of the Wicked, These Violent Delights, and Coraline are all going in Can't Stop Thinking About, because they are some of my favorite books. Kingdom of the Wicked, These Violent Delights, and also Illusionary are three books that I read for the first time this year, and I just know that they will be like some of my all-time favorites. Which is funny, because Illusionary is a sequel. It's the sequel to Incendiary. Coraline was a reread. I will always love the book, the movie, anything Coraline related. I'm here for it. Next up, we have Hunchback of Notre Dame. This is a picture book. I don't know where to put it. It was fine. It was the Hunchback as we know it, but like more for kids, but then it was still kind of dark, so I really don't know. And finally, we have a graphic novel called Menneskesønn, translated to, well, Son of Man. This is like a graphic novel of the biblical stories. I'm gonna put it in good. I really enjoyed it, and I do enjoy like the biblical stories. This is my tier ranking of all the books that I've read. I feel like it is rather even, like evenly spread, and there's not that many books in Not For Me. There is a lot that is like in It's Okay, but there is a lot more in Can't Stop Thinking About and Love It and Great and Good, and so I'm fine with that. I think that was all for this video, so thank you so much for watching. Please let me know what the best books you read in 2021 was. I need some more recommendations. If you liked this video, please hit the like icon, and if you want to see more of my bookish content, then please hit subscribe. It would just mean the world to me. Also, if you want to be notified every single time that I post, you can hit the little bell icon. Until I see you next time, bye!